Okay, so once all that, both sides are attached, we go back and finish this off. And it's basically just guiding yourself, starting at the top corner and turning it into like a V. Obviously it's cotton, so it's quite easy to actually turn. As we approach the metered corner, if you remember, we left this slightly in excess. Once we approach the corner, we just turn it at an angle and basically if you find it just slightly, you know, try and work it at a precise corner and try and not have like a dragging effect to this, because if you leave a slight bit of excess, what will happen is that excess tends to grow, and as you get further on, you will start getting more of an uneven surface. So try and work out that corner, even if you get a very marginal imbalance, it's going to be fine. But if you leave it and if you let that grow, then as your dress, you know, progresses, that tends to become more and more. Now you may have to, obviously, depending on your expertise, you can try this, doing this on perhaps just a piece of fabric with a bit of leftover fabric, and you know, try it out a couple of times to make sure that you get the metered corners right before actually attempting it on like a designer suit or something, because sometimes you can end up making a mistake, and you know, a mistake on something expensive can end up being a very, very big mistake. So I always recommend that, trying it out on a couple of times just to get yourself into the habit of how to go about doing a very precise corner, and you'll soon be able to work it out. It's not, obviously, it's not rocket science. I think it's important, fundamentally important, that we all bear in mind, right, that these methods and techniques are obviously advanced methods and techniques, and they're not always very easy to implement for a new, you know, new machinist. And that's not to say that you get disillusioned and, you know, maybe they're trying it out the once or the twice and you get disillusioned and you sort of end up giving up. So we've come to the corner. The corner, we're going to do like a pointed arrow effect. And once we've reached the top, leave the needle down, and we're just going to pivot the whole of the thing around and do the corner turning. Now this little bit is actually a tricky corner, because obviously we're trying to get the effect to be symmetric, and also the lace is a little bit bulky, so you need to sort of slightly experiment, and depending on just how much of expertise you have is the kind of result you'll get. So it's not something to get, you know what, even I won't get it absolutely perfect. I'll be honest, and the truthful answer is that it's not something that, yes, I have probably done this very long time ago, but usually once or twice is not sufficient. methods and techniques like this need to be worked on, and you need to do it several times before you'll become an expert. I mean, if we're looking at the expertise of tailors, then this is something that they would do on a regular basis, and that's probably one of the reasons why they're actually so neat and accurate. And also the fact that tailors tend to use techniques and methods that us women tend to find a little bit uneasy with, like using the iron, extensive use of the iron, extensive use of other certain, like you would see the tailor pressing it with hands and so on, and all these methods and techniques, us women tend to multitask, and we think we can just do it like this without the aid or the assistance. I think we don't actually take as much pride in our work. We're not doing it as a proper full profession thing, whereas the tailors are, and they're accountable and liable and so on. So I'm having a problem just metering out this corner. Okay. So if we lay this flat and figure out that we want to do, because it's, you need this extra room to be able to turn this into. So first of all, you need to do like a V point. then you need to do the V point towards the other side and even it out so that it's both balanced on both the sides, and you're working to do now is take this to the ironing board, give it a good press and see what kind of a result I've come out with. Trim away all the threads and all the... Now cotton actually manages to hold on to lots of threads as well, so it makes it look very unneat and very unprofessional. So what we need to do is slowly take off all the threads, and the other thing that I need to do is take away the sleeve, and I need to find an alternative. I need to find an alternative as I didn't have enough lace to go around the sleeve. So the only thing I have is extra fabric from the back of the dress, so I may have to just end up using that because there is no other fabric left. So I've got this, and I suppose beggars can't be choosers. I'm going to have to use this. You know, it will sort of blend it in with the rest of the suit. So I suppose it's back to changing the thread again, which I've changed in the course of this making this dress. I've changed the thread like 20 times. Said life was easy.